Welcome back to my channel. So today I am back and I'm so happy to be back. Today I'm going to be sharing some tips for starting a YouTube channel. So if you guys have not already, make sure to hit that notifications bell that we get notified every time I upload. And if you have not already, make sure to hit that subscribe button and also make sure to leave a like down below. And if you don't know who I am, my name is Shelby and welcome to my channel. So without further ado, let's get on to start this video. Guys, so I know I may not be the most experienced YouTuber out there, but I have learned a few things from being on YouTube for a while that I want to share with you guys. That way you guys, if you guys want to start a channel, you guys have some ideas. So the first thing I learned is good content. Now, good content's not hard to find, it's not hard to make, nor is it expensive to make. So basically, all you gotta do is have the passion for YouTube and you'll have better effort into it. But also, make sure to make fun and entertaining videos. Try and make videos short. That way people tend to not click on the next video, because sometimes people make videos kind of long and boring. Always make sure to throw in some fun editing or something fun or short. That way people don't lose their attention span and click on the next video, because sometimes other videos may be better than others, and sometimes that's okay, but sometimes we want to be some videos that a lot of people want to watch. And a lot of the times, some of the best stuff to do is to make it short and sweet. And I'm losing my mind just a little. So the second thing is to love what you do. If you don't love what you do, then it won't turn out good. This plays a big factor into creating a YouTube channel, because if you don't love what you do, you're not gonna put as much effort as you will if you do what you love, and you're gonna find so much more happiness if you do what you love, and you're gonna drive at it, and you're gonna become successful at it. Now, if you're doing it for the money, I don't recommend you guys chase for the money, chase for your dreams, chase for what you want. Don't do it for the money, because sometimes money isn't guaranteed happiness. So always, always make videos based on what you love, and if you love it, chances are people are gonna love it and they're gonna support you, and you're gonna become successful at it. And I believe every one of you guys watching can do anything you want to drive for. If you can dream it, you can do it, and I've lived by that quote for every day, and it is by Walt Disney. I love it so much. I'm losing. So the next thing is quality. Now, quality can have a pretty hefty price tag sometimes, and sometimes we don't want to spend thousands of dollars on cameras and stuff like that. Always make sure to check with your family, is that I've learned. Always check with your mom and dad, siblings, cousins, aunts, uncles, grandparents. I got this camera from my older brother, which was nice enough to give me it. So basically, just try and check. That way you don't have to spend as much money, and maybe save some money for your DIYs or your products you will need for your videos. And honestly, that's the best step to making a successful YouTube channel, starting off with a budget and working that budget up to professional cameras. I'm losing my mind just a little. So the next thing is setup. Now, setup is not pricey at all, nor is it hard to make. However, it can be pricey depending on where you get it. However, I have some tips for you guys to find the best deals without spending a bunch of money. So basically, my tip is to always look for Black Friday deals. That is the best time to get steals on camera equipment and stuff like that, setup, lighting, all of it on sale. So if you guys plan on making makeup videos, try Amazon all year round. You can try Amazon. They have some great backgrounds and cute backdrops as well for really cheap. And if you guys want to make good videos as well, you guys can get studio lighting as well for really cheap. I know they have some sets that are like $20 for a light, a backdrop, and I think a few little tripods, I think. Also, if you guys want to buy a camera, try and get kits. That way it's easier and you don't have to spend as much money as you would if you were doing it by themselves. I'm losing my mind just a little. Guys, So the next thing is editing. Now, editing can be a little bit pricey, and sometimes a lot of people stress out, which you should not stress out whatsoever because it is quite easy to do and quite cheap to do as well. Now, if you're starting on an iPhone, sometimes your iPhone or iPad will come with iMovie. Sometimes you will have to buy it, which is about $6 or $7. But considering that next to a $60 platform for editing and a $100 platform for editing, I consider that a steal. And so basically, all you gotta do is just make your videos short and sweet and make them entertaining. That way you don't have to put as much editing into it. That way you get the viewer's attention and don't lose it. Also, if you are using more complicated stuff, I recommend you find some courses. Sometimes the editing platform will have some videos on YouTube, like a channel you can watch, and they will show you how to work the whole thing. So the next thing is your channel. So basically, I'm talking about your thumbnails and your channel art. However, sometimes these can be hard to make, but always make sure to check YouTube for tutorials on how to make channel art on an iPad or a tablet or your phone, because sometimes you get so much help from watching those videos, and let me tell you, they help in the long run because those people give you tips, they give you tricks, and they make it way easier than it has to be. So basically, always check YouTube, and if you can't find any tutorials on YouTube, always try and make your thumbnails and channel art bright and colorful. And always use a schedule, because if you don't have a schedule, sometimes people won't know when you upload, and that drives away some people. So always make sure to add an estimate as to when you will upload. Let's say you want to upload every 2 weeks. Just add that in, and you can change it whenever you want, wherever you want, and however you want. So now I've come to the end, and last but not least is your comments slash hate slash everything you need to know for YouTube. So basically, you can run into a lot of problems on YouTube, whether it be copyright regulations that you maybe didn't follow, or it was something offensive you said, or it was your comments. Whatever it is, here's how to handle it, is to always remove a song. Now, I've had instances where I've uploaded and it's on private and I realize that it's has a copyright regulation. Always try and cut it to less than 10 seconds. That way they cannot capture you and take over your video. And also, always make sure to watch what you say in front of the camera, because sometimes people can get offended and saying negative, hurtful, and sometimes offensive comments. So always make sure to keep some comments to yourself. Also, if you ever have haters, just slay the haters and delete their comments and report them, or block them, because that helps so much, so they cannot comment on your videos anymore. So that helps. But yeah, guys, I've come to the part of the video where I always hate to film because I have to say goodbye to you guys. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. Also, make sure to leave a like down below and don't forget to subscribe. And I will see you guys in my next video. I love you all so very much. Mwah! Bye! Guys, so I did a video last week and I was testing a DIY and I was blowing up a balloon with those confetti, you know, those confetti balloons, and I got confetti in my mouth and I recorded it. So yeah, roll the clip.
I had to go blow the balloon and I got confetti in my mouth. Ew.
Oh my gosh.